Okay, so I want to show a couple more techniques to add some detail to this model, specifically regarding the cockpit, because we need, right, windows to be inset some. There's a bunch of detail in here that we need to add. And obviously there's a lot more elsewhere. This is, if you go to popfirst.com or you search for X-Wing model used in the movie, right, this comes up. And this image actually has a pretty good show. I mean, there's no windscreens in this. And that's not like a helmet, like an X-Wing pilot helmet, but whatever. So what we're going to do, though, is you can kind of see how this frame works and that we need to be able to, we want to be able to push in for that glass. There's also this cutout in the nose. There's the cutout for the, these are the photon torpedoes. And there's all sorts of other cutouts in the wings and things, and you can kind of see how the engines are set up as well. And there's other panels that pop out. There's a lot of additional detail we can add, but showing you how to do this and maybe add this additional panel here is going to show you how to do those other steps as well. So we're going to try and keep this one, this section, quick because I need to go teach you all a class. All right, so here are the panels we're going to start with, right? We want to be able to have basically a frame around this and then pushed in a bit, and a frame around that and pushed in. So I'm going to start by attempting to do this with the inset tool. So I have this selected. I'm just going to select this top polygon, and I'm going to see if I can do it with actually both of these selected, because that would save us a bunch of time, and it would be at the same depth. So I'm going to go ahead and use the inset, which is this icon here, or the letter I. I'm going to click and drag and see what happens. And look at that. I get some beautiful inset geometry. Great. So now remember, inset just slides things in. It doesn't actually provide any depth. So then in order to do this, I need to use the extrude tool, which I'm doing the opposite of extruding. I'm pushing, right? So I'm going to go ahead and push this in. And I'm just taking a look to see. It looks like, yeah, if I push it all in just a little bit, then we are going to get that. But now the issue is that the way that I selected this, I want you to know, I actually need this ridge here. And that did not show up because of the way I had selected both of these polygons, right? So it's treating this these two polygons as one object. So what I unfortunately am going to have to do, at least for the inset step, which I'm going to hit the letter I, go back to inset. I'm going to select one of these at a time. I'm going to hit the letter I. I'm going to click and drag, and I'm going to inset that just a little bit. Then I'm going to use my selection tool. I'm going to select the top one, hit the letter I, and inset that about the same amount. Now, in this case, because I've already had to split these up, I may want to do the same amount of depth on these, but I'm going to do them in two steps. So I'm going to hit the letter D to get my extrude, and I'm going to click and drag. And you'll notice that my offset is set to, like, you can see the offset changing in my attributes, right, as I move this. So I've got my offset set to 1.97. If I come over here and I click on this panel, this offset is still set to 1.97. If I, if I click on the tool tab, I can click new transform. And what that will do is it'll take whatever settings I had here, and it will transfer them to this next thing. So now these are both set to the same depth, and everything is looking pretty good. We've got a, right? We've got a cockpit. Now I'm going to leave it up to you to, right, do these, this back window here. You'll note the top does not have that. There is, I know from experience, because you look through and they have like a tiny little viewport back here. You can go ahead and do this next part. You'll see it really depends on how you want to do it. It's kind of squared off there, which is somewhat similar to how this is. You might need to adjust points or whatever to get there, but you can use the exact same technique. And you might even say KK line cut and actually just do a cut here. hit escape, right? So now we have that geometry set. And knowing that we can use these, we can select these as a group and then use I for inset. And again, I'm trying to click off in space so I don't accidentally select or manipulate something else, right? I can do this to shrink this down a little bit. And then, right, I could use the letter D, click and drag, and I could either inset it the same amount that I did before or not worry about it if it's off by a little bit. And again, I can come back here, I can use my selection tool, select this, hit the letter I, click and drag to make this little viewport back here, hit D, and push this in just about the same amount, negative 1 point, close to 1.9, doesn't really matter. Right. Okay. So now I've got those additional details added. Right. Things are starting to look more and more accurate as we go. If I go up to the nose, this is something where, right, we don't actually have the geometry currently to do this little cut. And so I could either do a loop cut, which is actually going to be probably a little problematic because these polygons are going to be weirdly shaped. So I will go to my right view. I'm going to hit KK. I'm going to uncheck visible only. And I will chop this down like this. And chop this down like this. Now that I've got those, that additional geometry there, if I rotate my view over here, I have a bit more going on. And I could just go ahead and cut from here to there, hit escape. And in this case, right, I want this to drop down a little bit and kind of go straight down there, but be flush here. So what I can do is I can select those polygons and, right, I want to be able to have this edge stay here. Like if I rotate now, what it's going to do is it's going to push some down and pull some up. And that's not what we want to have happen. What we want is we want there to be a hard, like, straight edges on all three of these sides, whereas this should be relatively flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the extrude tool first and hit the letter D. I'm going to pull in just a touch so that I have those edges available. Then because I want things to rotate around here, I am going to I'm going to go ahead and take my enable axis tool. I'm going to switch to use the, well, I guess the coordinate system will work, right? I want to bring this rotational point to right about here. And we'll do a little bit of other manipulation too, but now that I've got that set, I'm going to turn enable axis off. I'm going to use rotation. I'm going to rotate that down a touch, a few degrees, not a whole lot, right? Maybe a bit more because this is supposed to be reasonably flat. I'm not quite sure why this icon is so absolutely tiny, but that's the case. And then now I can use the move tool, but I can, and I can lift this whole thing up until it's more or less flush. All right, so now I've got that additional little bit of geometry in the nose cone. These two points out here look like they might be a little bit too far out still, and there's a bunch of other work that needs to be done. But now we've got a much more successful looking model of an X-wing.